We were expecting a lengthy ban for disgraced Bulldog James Graham, and that was the result. Victoria Murphy has been at the judiciary all night, and Tory, it was over pretty quickly.
Yeah, it was, Brad. The panel only took about 5 or 6 minutes to come back with the guilty verdict. Graham arrived here this afternoon pretty confident. He pleaded not guilty, and the Dogs thought they had a pretty good case. They argued that you couldn't actually see Graham close his mouth or clamp down, as they put it, on Billy Slater's ear. They also argued there were several other incidents during that melee that could have caused the lacerations and swelling on Slater's ear, but the panel didn't buy it. As I said, they only took a few minutes to come back with that guilty verdict. The punishment, 12 weeks, and that was due to the fact that he pleaded not guilty and, as they say, showed no remorse. Now, Graham came out, but he didn't speak afterwards. There was just one statement from CEO Todd Greenberg. This is what he had to say.
We simply went into tonight's judiciary proceedings and spoke the truth. No spin, no angle, no secret, no early guilty plea for a reduction. We simply relied on the truth. James has maintained his innocence, and the club stood by him tonight and defended him. James is obviously shattered with the result. He'll now miss the opportunity to captain his country. He'll miss multiple games with us at the start of the 2013 season.
So, Brad, as you can see there, the Dogs are clearly very upset with tonight's ruling. They still maintain that Graham is innocent, and we're yet to find out whether the two test matches that he would have played for England towards the end of the year can be counted in that 12-week ban.
All right, thank you, Tory. No doubt we'll hear more about that tomorrow. AFL now, and Sharad Wellingham has tonight informed Collingwood he wants to be traded to West Coast, while Gold Coast assistant Ken Hinckley has met with Power officials about their vacant coaching position. He is now considered the favourite for the job after giving his presentation to the club's board this evening.
Just had a good chat, and we went through obviously a few things, and we'll see what happens from there.
Port Adelaide has lost defender Troy Chaplin to Richmond, while Geelong goalsneak Shannon Burns has signed a 2-year contract with Melbourne. Three-time Bathurst 1000 winner Jamie Wincarp has proven to be the man to catch in practice at the mountain today. Though as quick as he was, our man on the ground, Paul Cochran, did catch up with him a short time ago.
Brad, good evening. Yes, and the fastest man on the mountain today, Jamie Wincarp, he was. And, well, he joins us here right now. Jamie, good day for you.
Excellent day. Yeah, hey, it's always a good day to be on the mountain driving around, you know, practice laps, quality laps, race laps. But car was good today, although Thursday doesn't mean much. We're happy to be up front.
What would this one mean to you if you can jag a win on Sunday?
This one's massive. I got here on Tuesday. It's an unbelievably big crowd. It's a huge event as it is, but marking the 50th, it's going to be absolutely huge. So whoever stands on that top step of the podium at the end of the weekend is going to have their work cut out, and they're going to massively respect it.
You're the man to beat. Everyone's got you marked.
I think my teammate Lounsey, I think he's the favourite at the moment, but My car was pretty good today, so fingers crossed. What happens is, as the weekend goes on, the rubber goes down, the conditions change. Should we make sure our car's consistently quick over a long distance, but it's been good fun so far.
All right, Jamie, thanks for joining us. Brad, qualifying tomorrow. I reckon this man next to me might be the man
surfing
to beat come Sunday.
Terrific, thanks very much, Paul. And Jamie, well, Aussie surfer Kieran Pirro has pulled off a huge upset to advance to the quarterfinals of France's Quicksilver Pro. In drenching barrels, the world number 47 edged out 11-time world champ Kelly Slater and Gabriel Medina in round 4. And in mixed results for Australia, world number 2 Joel Parkinson and Bea Durbidge also progressed, while world championship leader Mick Fanning was knocked out, look at this, by this brilliant 10-point ride from American Dane Reynolds. As always on a Thursday night, one of Australia's leading bookmakers, Tom Waterhouse, joins us to talk through the weekend sport. Tom, it's a huge weekend of racing, especially for your mum in Sydney.
Oh, she's unbelievable. Yeah, this is where she shines, and it's coming to a day that she's done so well before, and I think she's going to do it again in the Epsom. She's got the second favourite, Fat Al. I think he can beat the favourite, Shootout. I think he'll be caught wide from barrier 10, and Mum's horse gets the perfect run and hopefully wins. She's got the equal favourite in the Metrop. She's got Glen Caddam Gold, which I think can go on and win a race like the Caulfield Cup or Melbourne Cup if he can get into those races. But the most exciting one and the biggest moral of the day is in race 5, number 1, Precia, in the Spring Champion Stakes. It's got a terrific chance, and is a $1.40 favourite, but I'm so confident that anyone that backs with me, that bets with me, gets their money back up to $25, or for $25 if they have it on her horse. And I think it's a moral, and she says it's an absolute superstar.
All right, written that down. That is very good news. Now, Tom, the Spring Carnival really kicks into gear at Flemington this weekend.
Yeah, does a what? The Turnbull Stakes is on. And this is a real form guide for the rest of the carnival. You see a lot of these horses firm in Caulfield Cup, Melbourne Cup and Cox Plate markets. I think the horse to really look out for is Green Moon. It's the $4.80 favourite. I think there's going to be a stack of money for it. Lloyd Williams, well, he knows how to get these horses to the Cup. And there's been a lot of money also for it to win the Melbourne Cup, $17 into $15 through the week. So I think it's definitely one to watch. And I can't wait for the rest of the spring.
All right, we look forward to a great weekend. Terrific, Tom. Thanks for your time. We'll talk to you next week.
Thank you.
Play of the daytime, and Melbourne shoppers were left doing a double take today when they spotted the fastest man on the planet taking a leisurely stroll through the fashion capital. Usain Bolt is in Australia on holidays. The Jamaican is laid back man as they come.
I'm good, man. I'm good. It's good. It's good. It's good. Watch it.
Watch out.
That's good of him, wasn't it? Bolt's trip down under comes to an end at the weekend before he flies out to Auckland. And not for the first time. He gets our play of the day. That was great of Kelly Underwood to get Usain to Chadstone today. You'd love to have another camera just on everyone else.
Yeah.
Walking around going, that looks like that sprinter guy.
That great man.
Yes.
He's a very cool customer, isn't he?
He is. But I was on the phone the whole time, wasn't he? Just strolling through.
Maybe he
not
was tricking, though.
I think
he
so.
He does that to go, I'm busy.
You'd hate the phone to then ring.
I'm sure he'd have legitimate callers. He is that big now.